A loud four-wheel drive Army-issued Hummer escorts me into the Dakota Dunes. We climb a secondary levee, which is a four-foot-high pile of dirt built on top of one of the main streets that curves through the neighborhood. Most of the homes stand empty, many with yellow ribbon attached to them, indicating that the homeowner has evacuated. A red or pink ribbon tells law enforcement officers that the homeowner has chosen to stay. We come across a home with a pink ribbon, but the homeowners are nowhere to be found, and the front door is left wide open. Highway Patrol Trooper Chris Holm checks it out.
Highway Patrol, anyone home? This is one of the homes that had residents in it. The Border Patrol, they're helping us out with our security detail. They noticed that the door was open, so we just did a quick security check, make sure there wasn't anybody laying in there hurt or someone pillaging them or anything like that. From our best estimate, there's nobody in there, is that the people have finally evacuated. They're going to notify the sheriff's office at the command center that the people have evacuated, and then we're going to change the color of the tape so that we know that this home has been evacuated. So if there's a levee breach and we have to get people out, we don't waste our time trying to find people that aren't here.
13 families have chosen to stay in their homes, but according to Trooper Holm, many of those families won't stay long.
If I had to guess, those 13 would probably be out by the end of the week, because once they're out, they can't get back in. So, I mean, they have no one to bring food to them or anything, so they're eventually going to have to leave.
While few may choose to stick it out, others left immediately.
Different levels of evacuation. Some people just grabbed their billfold and purse and headed out the door and left everything behind. Others took everything and removed all the drywall and insulation out of their basements. We've seen that quite a bit, where folks are anticipating their basements to flood, and then they're trying to cut down on the mold from forming after the water evacuates.
Holm also must be on the lookout for looters and thieves. As we drive deeper into the neighborhood, we see more yards filled with drywall and carpet. We approach the main levee, where the Missouri River is already climbing. One side of the levee are picturesque turquoise blue swimming pools and million-dollar homes. I expect to see piles of sandbags placed as a protective barrier to keep the muddy waters of the Missouri out. Over half the homes we toured had no sandbags around their homes at all.
Most of the houses aren't completely sandbagged. Everyone's counting on the levees to hold. This one's built at 1,100 feet above sea level, and they're predicting the crest at 1,098 feet, so they built in 2 extra feet of security measure there.
It's those 2 extra feet people are counting on to protect their homes from floodwaters. Gavin's Point Dam increases its releases to 150,000 cubic feet per second on June 14th. 24 hours later, the increased water reaches the dunes. Those patrolling the area will continue to guard the homes from thieves. But without extra sandbags, it could be the Missouri River that robs these homes. For South Dakota Public Broadcasting, I'm Stephanie Rissler.